Carcinoma of the stomach. The incidence of carcinoma of the stomach, like all malignancy in the GIT, which is more in male above 50 years. What are the predisposing factors for gastric carcinoma? The risk factor and the predisposing factor for gastric carcinoma, write a note on the side of your paper. Beside predisposing factor or risk factor, write A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. A is the first and the most important predisposing factor for gastric carcinoma, which is achlorhydria. Absence of HCl. Gastric mucosa is so weak, devitalized, without any capacity to produce HCl or gastric secretion. Achlorhydria and the hypoacidity are very important and the most important predisposing factor for gastric carcinoma. And in MCQ, if there is an MCQ about predisposing factor for gastric carcinoma, the most important predisposing factor is achlorhydria and hypoacidity. Why? Gastric acidity is protective against gastric carcinoma. Why? Normal gastric mucosa, which has vitality and viability, containing goblet cells, secreting thick mucus, protecting the normal gastric mucosa from the normal HCl and gastric acidity. But malignant cells have goblet cells? No. Without protection. And if any abnormal cell without goblet cells, without thick mucus protecting these cells, HCl destroy these cells. But in absence of goblet cells in malignancy and in absence of HCl, the abnormal cells remain, proliferate without HCl protection, producing gastric carcinoma. What is the cause of achlorhydria and devitalization of gastric mucosa? Chronic gastritis due to any cause. Chronic gastritis may be due to irritant foods, D, dietary. Irritant foods like spirits, spicy foods, excessive smoking, sepsis. These are the four S: sepsis, spirits, smoking, spicy foods. These four S are predisposing factor for malignancy from the lip to the stomach. And these irritant foods producing chronic gastritis, which may end by malignancy. In achlorhydria, the bacteria inside the stomach and inside the GIT, acting on the food, producing carcinogenic material, leading to chronic gastritis. Gastritis also may be occur due to atrophic gastritis, atrophy of gastric mucosa. or autoimmune gastritis. Autoimmune gastritis produce chronic irritation ending by malignancy. Also, dietary factor very important is preserved food, especially preserved meat. The most important preservative are nitrates. If you eat nitrates in presence of a chlorhydria, the bacteria change nitrates to N-nitroso compounds, which are highly precancerous. Gastritis may be due to chronic infection with Helicobacter pylori. We all know that Helicobacter pylori passes through two stages. Early stage of chronic irritation of gastric mucosa producing excessive HCl with hyperacidity, but with very long duration of infection with Helicobacter pylori. This may lead to atrophic gastritis and hypoacidity after many years. Chronic gastric ulcer. Chronic gastric ulcer rarely turn malignant in less than 1% of cases, and actually most surgeons believe that chronic gastric ulcer turn malignant is usually due to bad diagnosis. The ulcer is malignant from the start, and the surgeon diagnosed the early malignant ulcer wrongly as chronic gastric ulcer, and later on advanced gastric carcinoma appear in this ulcer, and the surgeon said that the chronic gastric ulcer turned malignant. Therefore, actually, chronic gastric ulcer is very rarely turned malignant. Hereditary factors, gastric carcinoma may run in families, especially in patients with blood group A. Post-gastrectomy and post-truncal vagotomy. We all know this operation lowers the acidity, and as any hypoacidity predisposed to malignancy. Plus, after this operation, post-gastrectomy or post-truncal vagotomy, the patient may have reflux biliary gastritis, and the bile is very irritant to the stomach. Pernicious anemia is actually not a risk factor. It is actually association. There is high incidence of gastric carcinoma with pernicious anemia, but actually this is association. Why? Atrophic gastritis, chronic gastritis, leading to deficiency of intrinsic factor needed for absorption of vitamin B12, which leads to pernicious anemia. Therefore, pernicious anemia is actually association, not a risk factor. Any benign tumor in the stomach, especially diffuse bulbosis of the stomach, precancerous and may turn malignant. Therefore, write the ABCD, and the A is a chlorhydria with pernicious anemia, B benign tumor, C is chronic gastric ulcer, D dietary factors, leading to chronic gastritis for S. And E, emotional stress, because emotional stress for long time predispose to hyperacidity and chronic gastritis. If following post gastrectomy and post truncal vagotomy. G, genetic, especially in patient with blood group A. H, hypoacidity and Helicobacter pylori. These are the predisposing factor of gastric carcinoma. What is the pathology of gastric carcinoma? Gastric carcinoma in the upper third, about 50% of cases occur in the upper third of the stomach. And this is the reverse of the old percent in the past. Upper third representing now about 50% of cases. Less commonly about 30% in the pyloric region, the reverse of the old incidence. And please, on this picture, put the recent incidence. The recent incidence is upper third 50% and lower third is about 30 to 35%. And the diffuse infiltrating carcinoma of the stomach, about 10%. This is the recent incidence of carcinoma of the stomach, and please correct this old drawing. Upper third 50%, lower third 30 to 35%, diffuse carcinoma of the stomach, about 10%. Grossly, what are the gross picture of carcinoma of the stomach? First of all, stomach is a wide organ, especially in the fundus and the body of the stomach. And in wide areas of GIT occurs this type, which is called the proliferative type, which form fungating ulcerated cauliflower mass with area of hemorrhage, necrosis, and degeneration on its surface. This is a general rule. In wide areas of the GIT, the rule is proliferative type, like fundus or body of stomach or cancer cecum and right colon, wide area. The proliferative type may be followed by deposition of excessive amount of mucin in the tumor. And now it is called mucoid or colloid type, which is highly malignant, rapidly disseminating, poor prognosis, this mucoid type. The tumor may be in the shape of a malignant ulcer. Malignant ulcer usually occur on the lesser curvature or in the pyloric region. And it carry all manifestations of malignancy, like that elevated everted edge, dirty necrotic floor. Less commonly malignancy may occur and spreading through all layers of the stomach. Mucosa, submucosa, muscle layer, serosa, and spreading to whole lengths of the stomach. Marked severe sickening of all layers of the stomach by malignancy, infiltrating the whole lengths of the stomach. This is the shape of Linitis blastica, or also called leather bottle stomach. For Arabic student in Arabic, بقت يا جماعة الاستومك ده بالمنظر ده شبه عبوات المياه المينرال ووترز، عبوات المياه المعدنية البلاستيك، بتبقى معرقة كده هو نوع الريجولار. The stomach transformed into narrow irregular tube like plastic of the mineral water, or the shape of leather bottle. In Arabic, for the Arabic student, عارفين القربة الجلد اللي انتوا بتحطوا فيها مية سخنة عشان دفي رجليكوا في الشتاء، اما بتبقى فاضية القربة الجلد دي، اما بتبقى فاضية كده بتبقى narrow irregular tube like Linitis blastica. Therefore, diffuse infiltration of all layers of stomach and the whole length of the stomach, giving the shape of Linitis blastica or leather bottle stomach. These are stomach and the malignancy in the stomach in seen in all countries except in Japan. Why? Due to the food habits in Japan and the spicy foods, excessive spirits, etc., the incidence of carcinoma of stomach in Japan is very, very common. Therefore, in Japan, there is a screening program by gastroscopy to visualize annually the stomach. And in Japan, they discovered carcinoma, in situ, localized to the mucosa only. And in Japan only, the following types are seen as early gastric carcinoma. Early gastric carcinoma localized to the mucosa may be protruding. Elevated above the surface. Or the reverse may be excavated. Depressed below the surface. Or may be superficial type. The superficial type may be slightly elevated, may be flat on the same surface of the gastric mucosa around, or may be slightly depressed. Therefore, in Japan only, these early types of carcinoma may be seen in the screening program. Protruding type, elevated above the surface markedly, or the reverse, excavated type, depressed markedly, or in between flat or superficial types, which may be flat, slightly depressed, or slightly elevated. Therefore, in Japan, they divide gastric carcinoma into early. These types, protruded, excavated, or superficial. But all over the world, other than Japan, the marked advanced carcinoma is seen as proliferative type in wide areas, or ulcerative type on the lesser curvature or pyloric region, or diffuse type. There is a trick movement or trick in this diffuse type. During endoscope, the diffuse type, the mucosa may apparently normal, leading to misdiagnosis of this diffuse type, leading to late diagnosis. Microscopically sure, the stomach is lined by columnar secretory mucium. Therefore, most cases, about 95% of cases, are adenocarcinoma. And the adenocarcinoma may be, this is a diffuse carcinoma of the stomach, lianitis plastica. Stomach transformed into narrow, irregular tube. Microscopically, the adenocarcinoma in all GIT may be columnar cell adenocarcinoma. Malignant cells are arranged in irregular and ill-defined acini lined by malignant cells. This is called columnar cell carcinoma. The same shape, columnar cell adenocarcinoma, mucin, excessive mucin may be collected inside the cells, inside the acini, inside the tissue spaces, and in this case, it is called mucoid or colloid carcinoma. We all know if this is a cell with a nucleus inside the cell. In mucoid or colloid type, the mucoid collect, pushing the nucleus to the periphery. And the cells becomes signet ring appearance. Therefore, in mucoid or colloid type, the malignant cells become signet ring because inside the cell, excessive mucus pulls the nucleus in the periphery, and the nucleus in the periphery gives the cells the shape of a signet ring. There is another type histologically called spheroidal cell adenocarcinoma, in which masses of spheroidal cells are separated by variable amount of fibrous tissue stroma. These are the microscopic picture of adenocarcinoma, which occur usually in about 90-95% of cases. Exception, a 5% of squamous cell carcinoma may occur in the upper third of the stomach. Why in the upper third of stomach? Squamous cell carcinoma may occur due to metaplasia, chronic irritation ending by squamous metaplasia and squamous cell carcinoma. But ask yourself, why squamous cell carcinoma occur in the upper third only? Most probably it is a spread from the squamous epithelium above the stomach. Therefore, squamous cell carcinoma in the upper end of stomach usually spread from carcinoma of the lower end of the esophagus, or it may be due to metaplasia. Staging of carcinoma of the stomach. The famous staging TNM classification. T sure is a primary tumor. N is the node metastasis. And M is the distant metastasis. TIS, which means the carcinoma in situ. Malignancy localized to the mucosa above the basement membrane. T1 tumor invade the lamina propria or muscularis mucosa or submucosa. In this stage T1, the submucosa containing sublymphatic and some blood vessels, and if we reach to the submucosa, there may be a risk may occur lymphatic or blood spread, but this is rare. What common T2? T2, if the tumor spread to the muscularis mucosa, to the muscle layer, which is rich in lymphatics and rich in blood vessels, and here common blood and lymphatic spread. Therefore, spread to the muscle layer is carrying a bad prognosis. And in our countries, most cases, all over cases, all cases, usually presenting by infiltration of muscle layer and subserosa, which is T3. Infiltration to the subserosa. T4, infiltration of serosa and surrounding structure. Therefore, infiltration of muscle layer is an important prognostic factor. And this is why most cases of gastric carcinoma presenting usually inoperable, incurable cases, because they are present usually at least in T2 or T3 or even T4. And node metastases. All we know, N0, no regional lymph node metastases. In gastric carcinoma, N1, affection of 1 to 6 regional lymph node by lymph node metastases, from 1 to 6. N2, from 7 to 15 regional lymph node metastases. N3, more than 15 metastases in the regional lymph nodes. 0, N1, 1 to 6, N2, 7 to 15, N3, more than 15 lymph nodes. Sure, we know that M is the distal metastases. Either M0, no distal metastases, or M1, there is distal metastases. This is the pathology of carcinoma of the stomach.